identify what the issues are, the concerns are, and there are no debates, no change is going to happen. So all that area where these concerns are being explored, these issues are being explored, debates are being held, and repositionings take place, as a result of this, become a part of gender studies. There are different approaches to fundamental concepts instrumental in shaping the development of gender studies. So it's not just, I've been talking about the feminist movement, but that's not the only approach. There are various other approaches. So you can understand how broad the area is. The concepts instrumental in development of gender studies include four parts, that is knowledge, power, body, and gender. Unless and until these four areas, you know, the concepts that are instrumental in developing, if you want to bring about a change, knowledge is very important. There cannot be inequality as far as knowledge is concerned. If boys are educated, girls also need to be educated, so there is equality. In fact, I'll go a step forward and talk also about the transgenders, because we are talking about gender studies, so even queer theory comes under this branch. So any of these genders, you cannot deprive them from education. So it's a key concept where knowledge plays a pivotal role, a very significant role in the development of gender studies. Without knowledge, no development is ever possible in this area. We talk about power. When we talk about power, we know that men and women, for instance, enjoy different powers, or rather men enjoy more power. When we look at the society, you know that the more people in positions of power are males, and the females are relegated to the domestic kind of activities, which prevents them from enjoying power positions in society. So these areas also need to be explored. These concepts also need to be understood if we have to delve deeply into the study of gender studies. Body plays a major role. It's a key concept, because you're born a man or a woman would decide what your standing in society is, what you can expect from the society, what positions you would enjoy. So that plays a major role. And then gender per se is also. Now we look at the profound impact of the second wave of feminism. It is after the radical movement, the radical feminism that came about, that this gender studies gained much deeper ground. So the second wave of feminism, which we call as the new feminism or the radical feminism, which had impacted this particular branch of gender studies to a great extent, because the first wave, which we call as the suffrage movement, did not have much scope there, because it was very focused. It was only to do with the right to vote, and that was achieved, but that did not bring about a social change to the extent that women are at equal power with their male counterparts. So there are a lot of things that need to be, radical changes need to be brought about. Exposing androcentrism is a very, very important part of gender studies. What do you mean by the term androcentrism. Andro means male, and centrism is center or focal point. So male is the center or the focal point of attention in a society. And as you see that the discrimination begins right from the childhood, and you find that this has to be exposed. This has to be. So gender studies play a significant role in exposing androcentrism in different fields, be it history, be it sociology, be it even psychology. You have psychoanalytic studies taking place where there is a clear-cut discrimination. You try to expose these androcentrism by shifting male as a center. And it's to bring about, there has to be a repositioning here. So as we look at literature, we will find that a lot of books have been written by feminist writers in particular who believe in this, who play a major role of an activist to bring about a social change. And they try to, through the characters, through the themes, they try to reposition the status of women through their writings. So it can be exposed in various forms. It is not just restricted to literature. You have media, which can play a role. You have films, which can play a role. You have theater that can play a role. So you can expose these androcentrism through different, in different way, different manner. It need not be only through literature or through writings or debates and discourses. There are other, through paintings, for instance. The main point that I am trying to make is that you need to expose this androcentrism, and that exposing androcentrism becomes a part of the gender studies. We talk about the dichotomy between gender and sex is crucial to gender criticism. Gender criticism also part of gender studies. So you know that dichotomy between gender and sex. So how do we, there is a confusion here as to many critics, gender is a social and cultural construct while sex is biological and natural. So when you are born, you say that it's a male child is born or a female child is born, which is a biological fact and which is a natural fact. But what many of the critics here try to say that sex is crucial to gender criticism, both the dichotomy, the confusion between the gender and sex, because gender is a social and cultural construct. So sex is something biological. You cannot bring about change. Now that there is also, you talk about the, medical sciences and all, we have other branch altogether. We are not going to discuss that part. But sex is biological and natural, whereas gender is a social and cultural construct, which has to be, the existing, if it is not a very just way, where if there is inequality, it needs to be changed. And how this change takes place, it's only through discourses, through debates, through by reflecting upon, by exposing the unacceptable norms of the society. Sex is associated with biological reproduction. Gender is a notion of masculinity and femininity. So when we look at, sex, as I said, is a biological aspect. It is associated with biological reproduction. Gender is a notion of masculinity and femininity. Now, when we look at the Western culture, it is structured on gender, race and class, particularly the differences among these three categories. The fourth category, sexuality, has been added. So all these concepts have come from the West, and the Western culture is basically structured on gender, race, and class. So the differences among these three is what we are talking about. In the 20th century, when we talk about patriarchy and feminism, it is because of the patriarchal society that the feminist movement came into existence to eradicate that inequality, to remove inequality, and to give women their equal rights and the equal due. In the 20th century, feminists used this concept to expound the social arrangement of male dominance over women. So it's in the 20th century, feminists used this concept, the gender, to expound the social arrangement of male dominance over women. Feminism is an important concept in gender studies. Like we talked about other things, feminism is also very, very important. Gender studies is a political field of study. It raises question of power in society. So it is more a political thing. As I said, private things become more, personal things becomes political, because it becomes a debate, it becomes a topic for debate. It's open to the public, and therefore it takes a political turn. Gender studies is a political field of study. It raises question of power in society and how the balance of power can be made more equitable. So the entire concept of gender studies is striving to make to bring about a balance of power, be it between a male and a woman, a female, and to make it more equitable to everyone, to bring about equality. Feminism and economy is also a part of gender studies. As you say, that when we look at a female, the opportunities that they get, or rather what they do at their domestic front, is not something which generates money. They are not paid for what they do at home. It's an unpaid labor. From there, this idea has come up: feminism and economy. Feminism examines the gendered nature of different types of economic systems, so such as feudal, socialist, and there are various economic systems: feudal, socialist, and capitalist. All these become a part of gender studies. Feminism and gender studies. You have women studies gave feminist activists information and insights. Without this movement, women's studies would not have come up. So feminist activists through women's studies got information and insights. The biases and omissions are pointed out in various academic disciplines, be it history or sociology. We also have other concepts which are related to gender studies. Masculinity, like if you're born a boy, you're expected to behave in a particular manner. You're not supposed to weep. You're supposed to, seek employment, look after your family, earn livelihood. All these things, become a part of masculinity. So there are, again, the society has laid down norms. We talk about gender discrimination. You find gender discrimination at various places, be it workplace, be it at home. So this in society at large, you can find this kind of gender discrimination, which is also a concept very clearly related to gender studies. We talk about women's empowerment. Why? Because women do not enjoy the kind of position or power which a male counterpart enjoys. So therefore, the feminist movement came into existence, and women's empowerment is a concept which is very closely related to gender studies. And we quickly look at the three waves of feminism which were instrumental in bringing about this change. The first one, the suffrage movement. The second is the radical feminism or the new feminism. And the third one is transversal politics. This can be discussed in detail later on. The summing up of the gender studies include, you talk about gender, what gender is, trying to understand what gender is, trying to understand the gender as a social construct. Then what are the key characteristics of the gender studies? That is of prime importance. We talked about that gender studies is interdisciplinarity, its reflectivity, as well as its non-conformity. These are the three characteristics which we discussed today. The third most important thing that we discussed was the importance of gender studies, because gender studies play a major role in bringing about equality, equanimity, as we call it, and to bring about a kind of a society that is that gives equal rights to every individual, irrespective of the sex to which they are biologically born. Thank you.
Santham, All Gujarat Integrated Classroom.
Satellite na madhyam thi jodti kadi, etle Santham.